Alright, so already this evening I've been to Bellevue Mall. I know it sounds like, oh, Bellevue Mall, you've been like to the Valley Girl Time City. But the Bellevue Mall is a specific place for artist gallery, gathering zone, where there's another gallery and another gallery and another gallery. And so with all these galleries, it is a plethora. A plethora of starts, and I'm talking an entire mall. An entire mall created for us. And so there we go. There we go. So when we have the Bellevue Mall there, yow. Yow. It's like the Louvre. You take the size, big, large, like the Louvre, but yet it is available for us to commerce in. Commerce. And so with this endeavor, gosh dang it, you guys, oh my gosh, this is not just some silly one city metropolis. This is becoming big time. This is becoming a world. And so when it becomes a world, what are we gonna do? We're gonna have to step back, little local yokels, and we're gonna have to realize that we're gonna bring in somebody bigger, bigger again and again. And we're gonna have competition. And yeah, I'm very proud of it. I think it is a phenomenal beast that has started. And yeah, Vlada Valley, the Valley Mall. I know, what a weird thing. I would never think the Valley girl's name image. But yeah, the Valley Mall. Valley View. Wow. So it's an endeavorance of paints, waters and oils and temperas and inks, all types, abstracts, realisms, just brought in as a sellant locational. And so I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. Be the com the to be the competition announcer, because that's what I am right now. I'm the competition announcer, and yet I don't even have my own paintings that are ready to throw out at you. What a cheat! What a cheat of a life this has been to me so far. That this part, I'm just merely the disc jockey, a disc jockey of commercialism to sell the others. Gosh dang, gosh dang. The word isms, you should all be shot. You know, just what we say is in fun passing, in jest. Yeah, God does conjure up. You know, I'm better than this. I'm better than this. I should be there. I should be there on display. You know what I mean? I should be there on display. My artwork across the wall. Who are you, Mr. Tate? Who are you? And why am I not there? Why am I not there? I'm not impressed. I'm not impressed with your organization. There was only one, Mr. Tate. We have, I don't know, what, 20, 20, 30, 40 more galleries available and empty, just waiting for the plethora of artists. An artist begins to freaking go ahead and placate, show us, and I will do it. I'll do it. Okay, fine. You don't want to see my art? I'll write about you. I'll critique you. I'll critique you to the end. How about that for a job? Will you accept me at that? I'll critique you. I only liked Mr. Tate, the lilac and the polka dotted one. There was a polka dotted one and a lilac in the back, and that was the only one I wanted. All the others were turning into some statism. So no, I'm not really in love with you, but you are cute. I don't know, there was a few others. There were a few others that were kind of blue And looking abstract, and yeah, I kind of did have a want of the moment. Okay, I'll give you the blues also. But my gosh, what about the others? Empty, empty positions of stores waiting for artists to fill with paintings, with paintings, with paintings. Oh. It's like the pumpkin pie that you can never stop eating moment. Don't you understand? It is so great. It is so tasteful that it just makes me want to die again and again to relive. Gosh, dang it. I almost feel like just a grabber, like I will be anything right now. I will be anything. I will paint cartoons only. I will constrict myself. I will constrict myself in two. I will only paint black and white. I will constrict myself. I will only paint the subjects of the most former ridiculons of our time frame, meaning Rockwell. Rockwellians? Yeah, I'll even stoop there. That's how plethoric in availability. Hello, hello, hello. Any good artists out there? Hello, hello, hello. Are you ready? Are you ready to play Valley View Mall? It's all for art. Not for clothing. Not for are your shoes fitting correctly? Not for do you really want peanut butter brickle? Not for do you want almond hazed honey delectables for Christmas? Just art on your wall, stuck there, because you bought it. Now you bought the art, you have made a commitment. Because you've made a commitment to the art piece. Oh my gosh, it's a nasty beast on your wall. Did you really want it? Should you sell it? It's like a snake in your house, isn't it? It's a snake. Wraps you around and coils you at night. Do I want the snake of art in my house? Yes. Oh my gosh, can you please, can you please, can you please love me? Love me to death with its constriction. Can you please? What if it was the wrong one? Queries your eyes. What if it was the wrong one? I should have bought the other. Not the lilac, I should have bought the deep purple. Doesn't matter. You bought it. Don't you understand? You bought it. You're the beast who bought it. You took the plunge. You actually dove into the pool. Because you dove into the pool, you are greater than those who haven't. You dove into the pool, whether it was lilac or deep purple. Gosh damn, you are amazing. Don't you get it? Don't you get where love even begins to live? It begins to live right there. Even in your particular particular non-abstinence from the game, that you could partake in that communion, that particular taste, that wafer, that gift, wall to wall, eye to eye, human to human. Gosh, damn, you're good. Give me more, sell it. Get rid of it. Keep it. Goddamn, never get rid of it. That is the goddamn place where we live.